the so-called iniquity of certain members being financially involved in national projects. Members have ascribed to this state of affairs dark and sinister motives. I say if we in Parliament cannot gain from ruling the country, there's really very little point in our being here at all.
This House be given power to remain in office a further 3 years without re-election.
Yeah. Investigate the financial involvement.
It is 6 years since I handed over to you this great responsibility, in the hope that you would make good and wholesome laws which the people of this nation expected of you. I must confess to some abatement of my hopes for what has happened in my absence. Instead of uniting the good people of this nation with righteousness and peace, which would have been a glorious and Christian thing to have done, what do I find? Anarchy, corruption, division, and dissatisfaction. I say that the enemies of this nation have flourished under your protection. You were from the beginning a provisional government not truly representative of the people. But have the people elected you? Has this House gone once to the people it purports to represent? No, it has not. And now after 6 years of misgovernment, what do we find? Sir Thomas Fairfax moves a bill to give this House a further lease of this worthless and dishonorable life. Gentlemen, an immovable parliament is more obnoxious than an immovable king. They're drunkards, tricksters, villains, whoremasters, godless, self-seeking, ambitious tricksters. You are no more capable of conducting the affairs of this nation than you are of running a brothel. You are scum, sir, and a truly elected scum of that. This is no parliament. I shall put an end to your sitting. I hereby declare this parliament dissolved.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.